We will have much more on Governor Cuomo's address in just a minute. But first, the new legislature arrived to begin work in Montpelier this morning. The State House was jammed with lobbyists eager to get in a word right from the start as the House and Senate elected their leaders. And News Channel 5's Stuart Ledbetter is at the Capitol once again for us tonight. Hi, Stu.
Hey, Stephanie. Almost 30 new members of the General Assembly among those taking their seats today at a cold day here at the Capitol. Time was we thought there would be a leadership challenge on this day, but in the end, it all melted away.
Shap Smith of Morristown began a third term as powerful Speaker of the House. A long-shot challenge was scrapped before Christmas.
I, Shapley Smith, do solemnly swear.
In his opening address, Smith pushed members to accelerate universal health care, address real education reform, and crushing student debt.
Too few of our high school students seek a college degree. Many employers tell us how challenging it is to find qualified workers to fill job vacancies.
Next door in the Senate.
Vermont, I hereby open the 2013 biennial session.
A lot of new faces. The first order of business was choosing the president pro tem. John Campbell of Windsor had struggled the last 2 years, but at the last moment, Diane Snelling of Chittenden County dropped her challenge, reassured things would be different.
We are all individually responsible for our behavior and our conduct. There is not someone's job to make us behave. It is the honor system in the Senate.
We have so many opportunities ahead of us.
The Senate gave Campbell a second chance.
No big changes in the House, but the Senate is expected to reshuffle committee assignments. There could be four or even five big surprises by the weekend. All Senator Campbell would say is, I'm adamant about casting off all the bad vibes of the last 2 years.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
The big event Thursday is the governor's inaugural address. The lobbyists and activists jammed the halls on opening day to begin making their case.
And want to make sure that they know that people in Vermont are watching very closely what's going to happen this year, and we expect a lot of bold progress.
But money will be tight once again this year. The state's got to cut some spending if it's to avoid a deficit. And there are a series of contentious fights ahead over pot policy, wind energy, and physician-assisted death, all on the agenda. We'll have it here for you all year. Live from the State House in Montpelier tonight, Stuart Ledbetter, News Channel 5.